Come on, you'll be right.
I finally managed to convince Riley to leave Long Island.
Woo!
He's trying to take a good thumbnail footage!
Show everyone your top teeth.
Smile! I'm Elena, and this is Riley, and this is our home, Le Vagabond. We've been sailing around the world for the last 5 years and have recently found ourselves with a stowaway. Meet Lenny. Subscribe and welcome aboard. We've been anchored on Long Island for what feels like forever. As you know, Riley's been taking advantage of walking off the beach to freedive in a 202 metre deep blue hole. He beat his old record of his deepest dive. His new personal best stands at 57 metres. He hasn't stopped talking. He hasn't stopped talking about it, really. It's been so nice to see Riley so passionate about something. So apparently we had a bit of a wild night last night, but I didn't wake up to anything, which is like the first time ever. I think accidentally forgetting to open our hatch helped because it did rain, and I know that would have woken me up. You always get rained on and you have to wake up. You have to shut the hatch. But yeah, there were two massive storms that came by last night. Squalls, I guess. Riley was saying like 30 knots of wind. Our bathroom hatch stayed open and the floors all soaked. And we didn't have a clue, did we? No, we slept well. Yeah. Riley slept out in the saloon just so he could keep an eye on things. He's naked. Couldn't film. Trying to convince Riley to leave Long Island. I'm ready to start moving again, but he really wants to beat his record, so how much longer are we gonna stick around?
You could spend a lifetime here.
You could, but we've been here for a long time. Lenny's ready for adventure, I can tell. We're going to the Exumas next, and we're going to pick up Riley's mum, who's gonna come look after Lenny so that Riley and I can do some things that we can't usually do, freediving together. What else do you stop us from doing, hey? What else?
Having fun.
Oh, no. Emily, won't you take a slow ride with me? Well, you guys, I finally managed to convince Riley to leave Long Island. Woo! We've been here for so long now. I think we have literally done every single thing there is to do on Long Island.
You didn't see the caves.
Oh yeah, we didn't see the caves.
We didn't dive down to 60 metres.
You dove down to 57? That's good enough. We're going to leave today. Last year we only got to go to two or three spots, so the Exumas is a big chain of islands. Going to be amazing. Stick around if you'd like to check out the Exumas and subscribe if you're new here.
That's where the pig bit me on the arse. Well, I'm not very happy. I thought I'll go and grab all the rubbish that it's stolen and nicked off, and it was like thrashing it around everywhere. This other one snuck up behind me and bit me on the leg.
We will be going to Pig Beach, but he is not going anywhere near him. No, we gotta keep you safe. Hey, we gotta keep you safe. Here on my
own. Oh, it's blowing 10 knots directly behind us. So it's gonna be very calm and chill. I'm just gonna run this out the front and wind's coming from there, we're going directly down there.
It's been a while since we've taken this thing sailing, so there's always a few little jobs to do, we find. Show everyone your new teeth. Where are they? Yeah, we can see them. Oh, look at those. Baby boy's growing up, aren't ya? You're a big boy now. He's got two top teeth that are coming through. His two bottom ones are, yeah, quite a far way out, but he's teething and he's in a lot of pain, which means he does not want to be put down ever, do you? So they're gonna carry you around all day and night. I love papaya. I'll never forget when I did my 10-day fast in Bali. The first thing you eat after a fast is papaya because it's got really good digestive enzymes. And we had coconut yogurt as well, and it was just the best thing in the world. And yeah, so not eating for 10 days and then eating papaya obviously is going to make anything taste good, but this still tastes just as good, I would say. Huge papaya fan.
I've decided to run with just the Jenica, and because of that, the mainsail isn't being used as a backwards force on the mast. So this sail here, being only forward, is pulling the mast forward. So what you have to do is tighten up on the main sheet. So that's quite tight. And then that goes to the boom, which goes to the, I think it's the topping lift, I don't know. And that, if you tighten up on this, it all hooks in together and it provides a bit of backwards pressure on the mast so that your mast doesn't go shooting forwards. Not necessary today, but just an extra thing that I thought to do in case there was a gust of wind. Much more important in higher wind conditions, like if you were running with just a head sail and it was blowing 40 knots, then that's something that you definitely have to do.
No hat, no flailing. Leave it on. Leave it on. Leave it on.
Having Elena play the guitar to Lenny on the front deck here on the trampolines with that sail up in this wind is pretty good.
Just made some couscous for lunch. Couscous cooked in veggie broth, thinly sliced onions, chopped tomatoes, fresh basil from my plants. Olive oil and balsamic vinegar and pepper, and it's really nice.
Bad pasture. Sit and drink peanut oil.
Sweet. He's got peanut butter all over him.
Does he?
Yeah. Taking over the sea, drift me away from my dear. I can hear a calling. Such a lovely way. Tell me how you learned to forget. Tell me how you learned. Had a shower off the back deck, washed my hair. Feeling super fresh right now. And yeah, we're just making some water on the water maker, and Riley's gone for a swim over here to check out the reef next to the rocks. We're in a pretty nice little spot here. I love that sound of the waves slapping against the rocks. I haven't heard that in a while. It's so nice. What's happening?
It's like the biggest lightning storm ever. When the thunder hits, everything jumps.
Yeah, it's like vibrating everything. Got a bit of cloud cover today. It's actually really nice. We're gonna go to the beach for a swim. It's been a while since we've dunked Lenny under. Yeah.
Watered statue in the garden to watch it grow. I laughed when I was young, just because I was young. Never been.
Yeah, she's silly too. Come on. She keeps hearing me up by the stairs.
When she goes, she's going to go laughing. Some beautiful shells on this beach. The boys are just having a swim, and I'm going to go check out these rocks over here. There must be a pathway. This volcanic rock to walk on is like a nightmare. Should have brought my shoes. Ow, my goodness. This way it looks promising. I'm going to take this way. Oh, lizard. G'day, mate.
My old man used to talk about the time that would come. He gets too old to stoke the fire.
You have a good swim? Yeah.
She keeps helium by the stairs. For when she goes, she's going to go laughing. She keeps helium by the stairs.
Come on, you'll be right. Lenny, show everyone your top teeth.
Smile.
She loves
it. I'm not so scared of squitter and octopus, that's hilarious. He's trying to take a good thumbnail footage. He just looks so broken.
I'm trying to jump off the
I was like taking photos and politely saying, babe, I don't know if you're doing the right thing here. There's something not right about the style of jump you have.
Yeah, it's not my best work.
No.
Just try not to bear.
You just look broken.
Come on, one more.
Yeah.
This thing here is incredible. Look at this. You can really. Like it's no good to be up there, but you can really get a scrape on under here.
Yeah. So Riley's scraping the hull, Lenny's sleeping. I got Riley to scrape the other hull because he was scraping our hull and Lenny started staring, so I really don't want to wake him up because he's grumpy because of his two top teeth. And man, it is hurricane season. Soaking wet. Not just from water, it's just, you just sweat. Ridiculous amounts. Feels good though. I just gotta keep hydrated. It's kind of like a workout that you don't really have to do. Pasta and chill kind of day. We're both starving. We realized we've barely eaten all day and it's 4 p.m. so I just made a massive pasta and we're enjoying it under the shade.
Hey everyone, my name's Jamie. My soon-to-be husband and I have been watching La Vagabond for years and are now proud patrons of Riley and Elena's.
We love watching Vagabond because it gives us a sense of adventure and excitement, especially when we can't be on the water ourselves.
Like right now. Riley and Elena keep it entertaining, yet educational. We find ourselves inspired to reduce our waste, live more minimally, try Elena's healthy recipes, and, of course,
travel the world. If you love watching them as much as we do, head on over to their Patreon and contribute to their amazing production.
A huge thanks to Jamie and her partner for helping making these videos possible. And if you'd like to join the crew, I'll put the link at the end of this video. Join us next time as we continue on our island hopping adventure with friends.
Oh my goodness, there is a pod of dolphins swimming by the boat.
It's Delfino galore, you guys.